Yes, very good afternoon, students, and welcome back to our new chapter, that is body fluids and circulation, which is chapter number 18 of your syllabus. Clear? And as you all have already studied in your 10th standard about life process, and you all have already discussed about what is circulatory system in that very chapter. So just to again brush up your knowledge regarding this particular topic, we are just going to start about that what circulatory system is, or what is meant by circulation. So when we are talking about the process of circulation, circulation is a process wherein transportation of various metabolites takes place between various parts of the body. Clear? So it is the process of transportation of various metabolites between various parts of the body. Clear? That is what is meant by circulation. And when we are talking about various metabolites, the various metabolites that are included over here in transportation system is various kinds of the nutrients, various gases, hormones, antibodies, etc., etc. Clear? So now talking ahead about the circulatory system, that what circulation basically comprises up of. So when we are talking about circulatory system or circulation in human beings, it comprises up of two basic parts. Okay, that is, the very first is known as a circulatory medium, and the other is the associated parts. Or we can call them the associated organs. Clear? So when we are talking about the circulatory medium, here blood is the basic circulatory medium. Blood, it is said to be the basic circulatory medium. And when we are talking about the blood, it is very often also known as the liquid connective tissue. Liquid connective tissue. So, since the basic function of blood is to transport various metabolites between different parts of the body, hence it is also known as the liquid connective tissue. Getting my words? Clear? Now, to talk about the blood, blood is basically reddish in color. Clear? And it is liquid in nature, and it comprises up again of basic component parts. And when we are talking about the circulatory medium, it not only involves the blood, but it also involves the your lymph. Clear? So we are just going to talk about the blood and the lymph right up over here. So first we are just going to talk about the blood. Blood, the basic component part of the blood is the plasma, and the other is the the various blood corpuscles, or we can also call them the formed elements. So when we are talking about the plasma, it is basically a straw colored yellowish viscous fluid. So it is a straw colored viscous fluid, and it constitutes nearly 55% part of the blood, and constitutes about 55% part of the blood. Okay, now when we are talking about the component parts of the plasma, basically it comprises up of water. Water is the basic component part of the plasma, and it constitutes about 92% part of the plasma. So here the basic component part of the plasma is water, and it comprises of 92% part of
your plasma.
Clear? The others are various dissolved proteins like albumins, globulins and fibrinogens.
Clear? So here we are just talking about the various dissolved proteins and they are fibrinogens. Okay, another is globulins and albumins.
Okay, so when we are talking about the fibrinogens, they are basically associated with coagulation of blood.
So they are associated with clotting of blood.
When we are talking about the globulins, they are basically associated with the defense system of the body.
Globulins, they are involved in defense mechanism of the body. And the third is albumins.
Albumins, they maintain the osmotic balance of the body.
Osmotic balance of the body.
Clear? So these are the three different types of the dissolved proteins. Clear? Apart from that, the plasma also contains minerals, various kinds of the mineral ions, that is sodium, calcium, potassium, magnesium, etc. Clear? So this is all about your plasma. Clear? Now, talking about the various formed elements, what are the various formed elements and what are the various functions of these formed elements? So, when we are talking about these formed elements, these can be again categorized into three parts, that is the RBCs, the WBCs and the platelets. Okay, RBCs or the red blood corpuscles, or you may even call them the red blood cells, these are very often known as erythrocytes.
Also known as erythrocytes.
Clear? So when we are talking about these erythrocytes, these are basically biconcave or disc-like in shape.
These are biconcave.
Clear? And their number ranges from 4.5 million to 5.5 million per millimeter cube of blood.
So their number is 4.5 to 5.5 millions per millimeter cube of blood.
Okay, and their lifespan is of 120 days and they are produced within the bone marrow.
Their lifespan is of 120 days.
Clear? And again, when we are talking about that, they do not contain nucleus and mitochondria within them.
Do not contain nucleus and mitochondria.
So, talking ahead with the basic functions of erythrocytes, as we all know that the whole volume of the erythrocytes or the red blood corpuscles is filled up with hemoglobin, which is a colored pigment. Clear? It is a kind of a pigment and it has got higher affinity or higher tendency to bind up with oxygen. Clear? So
here they are having hemoglobin. Clear? And in an adult person, the range of hemoglobin is 12 to 16 gram per 100 ml of blood.
Clear? So this is all about the RBCs. Okay, now we are just going to talk about WBCs, that is the white blood cells or the
white blood corpuscles, and you can also call them the leukocytes. Clear? So WBCs or white blood cells, or you may also call them the leukocytes. Clear? So when we are talking about the leukocytes, these are large cells and they contain the nucleus. These are large and contain the nucleus, and their number is ranging from 6000 to 8000 per millimeter cube of blood, and they are again broadly classified into two major groups, that is the agranulocytes and the granulocytes. So talking about the granulocytes, and here it is, A granulocytes. Clear? When we are talking about the granulocytes, they contain granular cytoplasm. And they are of three types. That is the neutrophils. Eosinophils and basophils. Clear? So when we are talking about the neutrophils, they are basically phagocytotic in nature. Getting my words? And they have got role, these neutrophils, they are phagocytotic in nature. Clear? And they provide protection against various kinds of infection. Clear? Then when we are talking about the eosinophils, phagocytotic in nature. Clear? And they are having their role in allergic reactions. Clear? And when we are talking about the basophils, they are having their role in the inflammatory reactions. Clear? Now, talking about the agranulocytes. What are agranulocytes? Agranulocytes means those which do not contain a granular cytoplasm. And their cytoplasm is almost pale blue in color. Clear? Then they have a large colored kidney shaped nucleus. Okay. Then talking about, they are of two types. That is the monocytes and the lymphocytes. When you are talking about the monocytes, they are phagocytotic and motile in nature. And when we are talking about the lymphocytes, they are basically concerned with maintaining the immunity system of the body. And again, they can be categorized into two types, that is the B lymphocytes and the T lymphocytes. Clear? B lymphocytes that are developed within the basal glands. Clear? And T lymphocytes, they are produced in the thymus glands. Clear? And accordingly, they are having their function in maintaining the immunity system of the body. So here we are discussed about the WBCs. Now we are just going to talk about the platelets. So when we are talking about the platelets, these are very often known as the thrombocytes. Okay, now talking about the thrombocytes, they are almost disc-shaped in structure. Okay, and their number ranges from 150,000 to 350,000 per millimeter cube of blood. Clear? And their basic role is in clotting of blood. They are having their basic role in clotting of blood. Clear? So this is all about the formed elements. Now we are just going to talk about various kinds of the blood groups. So when we are talking about the blood groups, so here we are just concerned with the ABO blood grouping that is very, very commonly found in human beings. Clear? So it is also known as ABO type of blood group. Clear? And here the various blood groups, they are categorized on the basis of the types of the antigens that are found in on the RBCs. Clear? And accordingly, there are four basic type of the blood groups. Blood groups, that is blood group A, B, AB and O. So we are just going to talk about the rest part of them, that is what are the type of the antigens that are present on the RBCs, as I told you right now. Clear? Then antibody in the plasma. What kind of antibody is found in the plasma? In plasma. And the third is, can be donated. Can be donated to which groups? Clear? So talking about antigens, when we are talking about the blood group A, it is having antigen A and antibody is B. Clear? And it can donate its blood to A and O blood group. Clear? Then talking about B, it is having antigen B and antibody A. Clear? And it can donate its blood to B blood group as well as O blood group. Clear? Then talking about AB, it is having antigen A and B, and antibody that is found up over here is nil, and it can donate its blood to AB. Clear? And then talking about O, here the antigen is nil and antibodies that are found are antibody A and antibody B. Clear? And it can donate its blood to O, A, B and AB. Clear? So these are the four types of the blood groups that we are just talking about in the ABO blood grouping, that is blood group A, it comprises of A antigen, and the antibody that is present in the plasma is antibody B, and it can donate its blood to A as well as O blood group. Clear? Then talking about B, it is having antigen B, antibody is A, and it can donate its blood to B blood group as well as O blood group. Then talking about AB, here it is having antigen A and B, and the antibody found in the plasma is nil, and it can donate its blood to only AB. Clear? Then talking about O is having nil antigen, antibody is A, antibody is B, and it can donate its blood to all the blood groups, that is O, A, B and AB. Getting my words? Clear? So this is about the blood groups. Then we are also categorizing these blood groups on the basis of the another antigen, that is Rh antigen, whether it is present or not. Clear? Rh antigen, basically this antigen, it was derived from a monkey which is known as Rhesus macaca. Clear? The species is Rhesus macaca, and if the Rh antigen is present, then the blood group is said to be positive type, and if the Rh antigen is absent, then the blood group is said to be negative type. Clear? So this is all about the blood grouping. Next that we are just going to talk about up over here is the blood coagulation of blood. When we are talking about coagulation of blood, here we are just concerned about the whenever certain sort of the wound take place or certain sort of an injury takes place, then the blood starts oozing out. You must have very much observed that. And after some time, the blood stops oozing out.
So what is the basic mechanism behind that? It is the blood coagulation. Basically, blood coagulation starts up with a particular type of a protein which is known as thromboplastin, which is a tissue intrinsic factor. Okay, thromboplastin,
okay, which is a tissue intrinsic factor. In the presence of this thromboplastin, the inactive prothrombin, it is converted into the active thrombin.
Clear? And in presence of this thrombin further activates the conversion of fibrinogen to fibrin. Fibrinogens are again inactive in state and they are converted into active fibrins.
So this thrombin, it initiates the conversion of fibrinogens, which are proteins, again into active fibrins. These active fibrins, they are present in the form of fibers and they form this sort of a mesh like structure. Clear? And in this mesh like structure are entangled various types of the cells. It can be the mast cells, it can be the injured cells, it can be the various kinds of the microorganisms or the ruptured blood cells and so on. Getting my words? And as a result of which this mesh, it becomes stuck up. Means there are no open pores for the blood to further flow through it, and the whole of the mesh, it is covered up by various types of the cells or various microorganisms within it. Therefore, to obstruct the flow of blood through it. Clear? This particular structure which is formed results from the phenomena which is known as blood coagulation. Getting my words? So this is all about blood coagulation. Clear? So students, this blood coagulation, it is very very important, since if blood does not coagulate and the blood keeps on oozing out of your body, then what will happen? It will result into formation of excessive loss of the blood from the body, and which may prove to be fatal or lethal to the person. Therefore, blood coagulation is a very important phenomena, and not only this, various factors are involved in the coagulation of blood. There are 16 factors which are very very essential for coagulation of blood, and they are forming a clotting cascade. Clear? And some of the very examples of these coagulation factors, they are Stewart power factor, Hageman factor, Christmas factor, vitamin K, etc., etc. If any of the factor out of these 16, if any of the factor is absent in the coagulation cascade, then the coagulation will not proceed on. Means the coagulation power of that person is going to be very very low. Getting my words? That is, the clotting of the blood is not going to take place, and it might prove injurious, lethal or fatal to that very particular person. Getting my words? So students, in this topic we have already discussed about what is circulation, what are the various component parts of circulation. Still we have not completed up with the component parts. We have just completed up with the blood part or blood portion of the chapter. Clear? That is, we have talked about the various blood groups that are present within the living organisms. Clear? We have even talked about what is blood coagulation, what are formed elements and such sort of things. Clear? So kindly start reading up the chapter, and if there are any of the queries, then you may kindly ask me in my next class through StudyBase app or whenever we are just going to meet again in the school. Till then, thank you.